everyone, welcome to Kip TV. I am Kip. Today I've got a match for you on Arctic between two steel blue teams. Let's meet the teams. Let's get to the action. On the left in blue, we have Insane Gerbil Riot. And on the right in red, we have Golden Gents. Swordsman Scotty will be appropriately the demo man for IGR. We're going to call them the Gerbils. Very mean TF2 player is Spy. Acer is Sniper. Bombero is Pyro. Blizzy is Medic. Peyton Effing Manning is Heavy. Treeman is Soldier. Power Gamer is Engineer. And IMX Rumor is Scout. Over on red, we have Simulate as Soldier. Various is Engineer. High Power is Sniper. Random is Scout. Wills is Heavy. Hobo Freddy 55 is Demo Man. Marcuccio is Medic. Slamdolf is Pyro. And then S9 is Spy. So let's get to the action. We're going to watch Swordsman Scotty, who, fortunately, I guess for his team, is not running the Demo Knight. However, Demo Knight pretty viable on this map if he knows how to use it correctly. I've seen it happen and I've seen it work. However, he does a great job getting out there to mid. Doesn't take a lot of damage right there, so he is able to stay up towards the front lines, whereas his opposing Demo Man does have to back away. Hobo Freddy did take a lot of damage. He did fall back and get some health right here, though. Big headshot coming down from Acer takes out Wills the Heavy for AU, and looking pretty dominant mid-fight right here as Blue's Uber is rapidly rising. Actually, it's a crits right there, so they're going to have that in no time at all, and if they pop it soon, they may be able to prevent a red team from getting Uber as they are doing that regular medigun. So we will see if this pop comes up soon. Really, Gerbils need to push it, and here they go, finally pushing it. No, they are not. Okay, here they are. Now they are. They do pop the Uber. Crits come in, but the red Uber is popped just in time right there. An excellent pop from Golden Gents, as the crits is now pretty useless as Golden Gents continue to push onto the point. They need to clean up after that failed crits from Gerber, but Gerbil. Maybe I'm just gonna call him the Riot, but oh man, Hobo Freddy going down, Marcuccio going down, and Will's all going down right there. So Golden Gents losing a golden opportunity. That's a pretty bad pun. I think you'd call that a pun, but anyway, it was bad. Sorry about that. As they do lose the point, and Riot says take it for the first time this round and this match. Remember, we will play 4-3 here on King of the Hill Arctic. The first time Arctic was seen in UGC, very exciting. I think it went over pretty well. Of course, I'm casting this about like 2 or 3 weeks after it happened, but I think most people had a positive experience playing it. X right now having trouble finishing off this soldier, taking a lot of damage, and it will be falling back. We do have that under the point area, like sewer or tunnel, some people call it, that makes flanking and surprise visits really, really fun if you know how to use it properly. Often you'll see the combos coming in underneath and try to get something started right there. Both combos are, let's see, we still have the crits going for Blue. Oh, Medic taking a ton of damage right there, but somehow Bombero takes out Simulate and keeps his Medic alive. Blizzy now has 100% crits, but Marcuccio, I think, does have 100% Uber. He does. Uber is popped first. That crits hasn't even been popped yet. We'll see if Blizzy can get away alive. He's escaped to the under tunnel. Let's see. They don't know he's there. Oh, what a missed opportunity right there for Golden Gents. Blizzy is still alive, escapes the scout, but does pop that that crits. Doesn't matter, pops it on the NG takes down Red Medic, and what a panic crits pop right there. Blizzy does go down, but Blizzy in chat, you can see a shouting med down, and who took that med down? Oh, no big deal, it was just Power Gamer the Engineer with the crits. Always love to see that. But regardless of all of that action, Riot is still holding on to the point pretty well right here. They have this nice little setup. Have to watch out for bombing soldiers, as we see Tree Man right now trying to prevent his opposing soldier from getting top of the crates. That's really what you got to do in this match as soldier, is to control the crates. If you don't control the crates, you don't control the skies, and that makes it very easy for your medic to be bombed and Ubers to be dropped. Both medics are up though and have been surviving for the last few seconds. Pretty much Blizzy is just inside the dispenser right now getting that crits up. They need to pop it immediately. They know the other team is still running Uber, or at least they should know that. What is Wills doing? Pushing in way too far. Still overextending right there. He does go down. We do have a soldier on the crates, but that crits is ready. Should be popped immediately. Take care of this soldier, but they don't. Dizzy. Blizzy is so hurt right now. He goes down. Hobo Freddy with some huge stickies taking out the med right there. Doesn't matter better as Riot does recap, but I don't know about that. Losing way too many players in that was Riot, and Golden Gents now have a good opportunity just to push back. They do have about 90% Uber, so it's going to be relatively easy, or it should be. In theory, it should be easy for them to take this point back. We'll see in practice how it goes. We're at Toba Freddy as he gets some of these overheals that Uber is still ready and waiting. We'll see if they decide to pop it on. Probably Heavy at this point. Wills, a very capable Heavy. You may know him from the UGC forums, where he is probably the nicest guy on there, except if you call him Will, then he gets really mad. He's not just one Will, he is plural Wills. Anyway, they do take the point back. Uber has yet to be popped right there. Mercutio is just hanging on. We need to pop it now. There we go. Do lose the demo in that, and they're trying to get after the medic, but becomes separated by some nasty air blasting from Bibero. We do have a Uber Pyro as a last resort, but it looks like Pyro may be able to get out there. No, he doesn't get out, and Wills goes down too. However, it was Riot who took most of the damage in that. So, Riot won't be able to stop this continuing, well, it's not continuing camp, will not be able to come back with an immediate repush. They will have to gather and wait a bit. They do have a minute 30 seconds left, so it's not too high pressure for them. High power. Oh, did not get that. I thought for sure that was a heady shot, but just needs to be a little bit more patient. Snipers can have a field day on this map if they are not properly checked. So far, it looks like they, well, High Power is third place right now with points, so maybe we'll see. Maybe he's been preying on innocent little sentry guns, though. That's where he's getting his points. Hobo Freddy with some big stickies defending the point right there. Golden Gems doing a good job. Kritz is ready to go. Blizzy drop down with his goes down to a backstab. Drop down with Wills. Drop down with his Heavy Peyton. Not able to get that pop off net, able to survive. However, Golden Gents have just crumbled beneath that push. I'm not exactly sure what happened to the local presence that Golden Gents had. It looked like they had enough, but nobody left alive to stop that point. We only have 19 seconds for the Riot team to hold on, the Gerbil Riot, which I can imagine would be a very adorable Riot. I guess it depends on how you feel about gerbils. Anyway, we're going to see these last-minute efforts by Golden Gents to see who can get on the point. Looks like we have Invisible Soldier, we have a Demo Man, we have this Heavy, which is going to be a very big deal. Will's just coming in and mowing people down. He'd like to have a medic on him, but Mercutio is dead. However, he and this Pyro will be able to cap it, it looks like, as we only have a few up for Riot, and none of them are getting to the point. Right now, oh, Will's going down. Acer taking him down with a headshot. Acer has been doing some nice job controlling Wills. Who, again, like I said, is very capable, Heavy. Oh, and those mini sentries. Oh, those mini sentries. But it looks like, Riot doesn't have to. I mean, they can't drag their heels on this. They have about 20 seconds, but they don't need to needlessly throw their lives away right now. That's actually, it looks like, what Red Team is doing. Golden Gents, very desperately now trying to defend the point, whereas Blue, coming in here a little bit more passive. They have their medic with them. No, Blizzy goes down. These medics are having such a hard time staying alive. Both teams being very, very aggressive. We have Wills again coming out with the sniper, but High Power goes down to the mini sentry. Power Gamer with the work on the mini, and there we go. First round, it goes to Insane Gerbil Riot. I wish they had an easier team name to say. All right, we're gonna watch Hobo Freddy's rollout this time. So we're just 1-0, the gerbils. I suppose, and the gents are gonna come back and try to see what they can do best. Hobo Freddy getting a little bit better of a rollout right there because he didn't take as much damage, but now he is definitely taking some spam. Needs to fall back to his med, which he will do. However, that does enable Blue Demo to... Oh, but it just doesn't even matter! Blizzy goes down, simulate bombing in there, was not able to get... Blizzy was not able to get the defense that he needed, and that's why you gotta control the crates, gotta control the skies, and that should not have happened. Blizzy, oh man. That, yeah. It's very, very, very common on Arctic for medics to be bombed in like that. I saw it casting a couple Platinum games, and everybody died because of that. Play those type of plays from the soldier. So it's just a thing you gotta be aware of and you got to account for as a Heavy protecting your medic, as a Pyro protecting your medic. It's just... Yep. Anyway, we get Wills. He's got some nice tats, but we'll try to get some action here as red team controlling mid fairly well. Because Blizzy went down, they're at a severe disadvantage in terms of Uber and Uber charge. I'm not sure what Blizzy is running right now. That's a bad word. Blizzy is still in the crits, so they like what they're doing with the crits here, which I have no problem with so far. Since first round was so close, you can see that the crits did have its advantages as well as its disadvantages, just like the regular metagun did too. But we will see though how that continues. Safety potato, what is even? Taking down a sentry gun from across the map. Love to see that. He's still going for it. This poor sentry gun. Poor sentry gun by Barry, yes. We'll see if Safety Potato can to get something maybe a little bit more substantial. Maybe a knifing on a sentry gun. That would be pretty cool. A backstab sentry gun. I don't know what it's called if you do backstab a sentry gun. Meanwhile, Blizzy goes down while I was talking about stupid things. High power getting that headshot. Taking out that crits threat. And then here comes Hobo Wills and Hobo Freddy and their medic and just destroying everything that gerbils held close and near and dear to their heart. A really nice pop right there. And that's going to prevent the riot, is what I'm calling them, because for some reason gerbils is really, really hard to say today. And that'll prevent them from making any sort of push. And remember, they still have 3 minutes on the clock. Golden Gents have been the only ones to control the point right now. S9 got caught out like, whoa, and he is not going to survive this. Bombero is making sure of that. So some good spy checking right there. Red and their positioning here in it's called Elbow, Banana, Croissant, whatever. Looking pretty good right here. They have this level 3. Do they have a teleporter is the question. Yes, it is behind the house. So they're in good position to hold this for quite a bit. They have about 70% Uber, which of course is better than Blizzy because Blizzy went down. But Hobo Freddy is going to come in here and try to do some damage. Oh, and then that Swordsman trying to get in there and do some damage, but he is not. He's shut down by Wills right there. Mercutio is so hurt right now, taking a lot of spam. He's got to pop. Oh my goodness, he didn't pop and he didn't die. I don't know. He's really, really lucky right now, and they need to use this Uber because they know that Blue Team knows where they are. I'm going to try to get on Will's cam as Red Team needs to defend this point. They are indeed pushing right here as we only have about 8 seconds left. If they should just stand on the point with this Uber, they're going to try to get the spy and the dispenser, not the dispenser, and all of the Golden Gents are on the point right now, and we'll see if they can defend it for a little bit more time as a tiny carrot of blue goes down. We do have a regular level 1 or mini sentry on the point, and that will be the end of round 2. Golden Gents, pretty dominating round that time. They took the point and held onto it with their very lives. Definitely very nice defensive job done there. Oh, Swordsman Scotty got caught in on the wires? Not exactly sure what happened. I think he was confused as well. But that's what you get for not running Demo Knight, which they got right here. We do have this bomb in by Simulate, but this time Peyton Manning is all over. It takes him down, and Blizzy will survive with that. About 80% crits right now. They need to push on this when they do have the crits, and they need to just wipe Red. So far, only 4 up for Golden Gents, so a very good opportunity to to get on top and to get a morale boost out of this round. Blizzy does have this 100%. Mercutio went down, so no medic, and this is where you get to push forward and be jerks, or you get to stay on the point and just be not as big of jerks. Looks like they are going to push forward with the Demo Man a little. Still have that crits ready and waiting, but they want somebody to pop it on. Somebody to die for their crits. So far, still holding on. I'm getting on Swordsman Scotty's camp because he's the one most likely to get those crits, I would say. I'm guessing they're waiting till they find... Oh no! They waited too long and Simulate comes in, takes down Blizzy on that crits. Oh, the humanity. Blizzy is just having a hard time with that Simulate soldier. Not the simulated soldier, but the soldier named Simulate. Anyway, he's doing a nice job keeping him pretty much dead. Blizzy is up again. Mercutio went down, had about 60% Uber charge right there. But we already have some dominations going on. Wow, people getting those kills. was going to watch Simulus Cam, but he goes down pretty immediately as Blue is holding on to the point, doing a pretty good job right here. Let's take a look at their positioning real quick. We have the Soldier on the crates. We have Sniper up here. We have Dispenser right here. As you'll notice that the Riot have been putting their Dispenser by the crates, whereas the Golden Gents have been positioning theirs in the elbow. See what type of difference it makes? So far, it doesn't look like it. These teams are pretty closely matched, and it looks like they just have their different strategies, different techniques. Simulate coming in, taking down Acer. Now he's behind these lines, which is so perilous, but looks like Scout knows where he is, and Simulate does go down. Swordsman Scotty getting some stickies up there, and X helping out with that. Peyton Manning getting this crits, going after the med. Can he get Mercutio? He does indeed. Finishes off Wills right there, but then goes down to a backstab. Random getting that backstab. How random, but actually no, it's probably pretty well planned. Despite that, the crits did do quite a bit of work and decimating Golden Gents lines, losing their heavy classes right there, losing their med. Of course, Blizzy went down as well, so you would rather have your med alive, of course, but you gotta take what you get with that crit. Ooh, Tree Man going down. There was a level 3 up there. Interesting. Very interesting right there, play from Red Engineer. Very, yes. Of course, level 3 is not that... not that common on King of the Hill because it just takes so long to get up, but if you can get it up and get it to where a place where it can't easily be spammed down, it can be a very great defensive mechanism. Simulate looks like was... I swear I just saw a soldier. Okay, there he is. He went underground and trying to damage and put a little threat on the blue defense, but how... Gerbil Riot, though, holding on pretty strong right there. They've held on for the entire 3 minutes, and just like Golden Gents did last time, they take this round with their opponent still having 3 minutes. So it is 2-1, and complete reversal right there that Gerbil Riot were able to hold on for 3 minutes. So these teams are ridiculously closely matched. Let's take a look at points, and IMX, remember, has the most points right now on his team, so that means he's deserved some camera time. That also means I'm obviously not getting enough scout action, which is pretty right. Just try to see who's doing something interesting. I do want to get some scout cam, though, when possible. Interesting enough, Mercutio has gone to the crits, but doesn't matter when you get backstabbed by Safety Potato with a nice little sneaky move in there. He did die, but whatevs. Got the medic. Blizzy went down too, though, so I didn't see how that happened, so doesn't buy a huge advantage. However, when rest of Red Team is wiped out, maybe it does buy an advantage. Wills is trying to stay alive for anything right now. He is... a desperate man. We'll see if he can stay alive. He gets shot with the Crusader's crossbow from across the map and takes his health up to almost 200 right there. He's continuing on his little rampage. He is a man with something to prove. If he can get his medic and some support, there's his support. Let's see if he can't get another crossbow or maybe Sam to take a sandwich, but he doesn't have time for a break. He is going to win this game single-handedly. But of course, now he's got his medic on him and continuing to plow through to the points of Golden Gents making their comeback. Hobo Freddy did go down on the point. We saw a nice backstab again by Safety Potato. Safety Potato is gone, though. That threat of potatoes are gone. Oh, and you saw S9 going after Swordsman Scotty from Will's cam, and Will's like, I know how that's going to end. I don't need to continue shooting at Swordsman Scott. So there we go. Red does cap the point. Golden Gents trying to make a comeback here after losing last round, but they took the round before that pretty decisively, so who knows? We'll see. All right. Well, this isn't the blue scout that I wanted to get, but this is Random. So we'll see how Random is approaching being scout on King of the Hill. I was running into his opposing scout right there. They both have some pretty sweet unusuals, so I don't know who's going to win this. Oh, it looks like X does. So that means he has deserved some camera time. As Swordsman Scotty falling back, looks like he wanted to get over there, Latin. I don't know. I don't like this positioning by Red. They're way too close to blue action. It can easily be spammed down. You see the sentry gun going down. Here's the crits. And we'll see how Golden Gents can deliver this. Do they even know where Red Team is? They're up in the hallway right here. And they do connect, taking down Blizzy. Oh my goodness. And Mercutio goes down as well. Ooh, I don't know about that. Yeah, they weren't completely sure of that positioning by blue team, where gerbils were, where the Gerbil Riot was, and that showed in their pretty much a wasting of the first couple stickies of that crits. Finally did connect, but you gotta keep that medic alive. That's gotta be number one priority after that crits has ended. Alright, so I am X, remember me at logs. Show us what you got. Show us. Oh, now he's no longer. Oh, well, because there's four people tied points on top of gerbils. Doing some bonk action. Running into a scout and does take down a random. So I'm pretty sure X is winning the scout v scout battle. And when you can do that, that's very, very helpful to your team. Also, taking down the teleporter is going to be annoying to enemy engineer. He's not going to survive this, I would think. Oh, he takes down Hobo Freddy. So X, yes, we will remember you in logs as you have a nice little streak going on here. Oh, that spy. What a jerk. Oh, random in chat has said, that scout, I cannot shoot that scout. Oh, Blizzy goes down, high power, taking him down with a body shot right there. Sorry, I was laughing at the silly demo man and the silly scout, but sad things are happening too, like Blizzy being shot. We do, however, have 100% ready to go for red. Where are they and what is it? It is crits and it is popped. Just Hobo Freddy sending pills and spam anywhere he can. Mercutio, though, goes down before that crits is over. I didn't see where it goes. His skill feed went too darn fast, and I didn't notice how he went down. However, he is down, and that's going to buy Blizzy a bit of an advantage, because you saw Blizzy did go down earlier. And they are building. I like this decision. I like this decision a lot. Just be careful not to let X die, because right now he's been a pretty big player. Also, Power Gamer, we're going to have to get some NG cam time. We do have this crit's ready to go. Trying to give him the swordsman Scotty cam as he will get it. He has to pop it a little bit early and put his sticky way too close to himself. But Blizzy goes down. Simulate did get that rocket off and takes down his medic. Simulate going huge and just controlling Blizzy, just ruining Blizzy's day. Swordsman Scotty getting some spam in there, but Hobo Freddy is doing a good job taking out Riot's team. This looks like it may be the end of Riot, as there's some really nice defense here on the point, and indeed they do hold on, and that will bring it to 2-2. These teams are so crazily evenly matched. Alright, we're gonna get some X time on the cam, and then we're gonna get some Engineer time, because how do you play Engineer and King of the Hill? What a good question, viewer, to ask. I don't like to play Engineer on King of the Hill. It's pretty much set up sentry gun or set up mini, die. Set up mini, die. If you can get up a teleporter, that'd be awesome. But X in here behind medic, putting some good damage down on Mercutio. He was down to 7 health. Can he finish him off? No, not able to do it. Mercutio gets away alive, but X doing a really nice job right there. If he had a little bit of support, maybe someone to send some spam over near that house, they would have gotten Mercutio. However, as it stands, Mercutio is alive, but Blizzy has his 100% crits ready to go, and let's see how they use it. Popped on the Demo Man, Swordsman Scotty trying to find somebody to kill, but looks like Red Team has pretty successfully scattered, and Blizzy goes down to who else but Simulate, the bane of Blizzy's existence right now. And that's so frustrating, but again, he's not the only medic to curse soldiers on this map. He's just lucky that Simulate isn't running that Baker's Bazooka, which of course was allowed on this map. Acer taking out high power with what appeared to be a chest shot, but registers at a headshot. So whatever. And let's see if Acer can get one of these heavier classes and does connect to Wills. Some STV is a little off right there in terms of location, because that definitely was like a lower back shot. But whatever. I'm sure it was in real time. It was beautiful. We do have Golden Gents pushing onto the point, taking it back from the gerbils, who got a good bit of good 37 seconds off on the clock. Now Red is going to have to build up their little location here with the dispenser and everything right near the point. Let's see, how does Blue have theirs going on there? So far, I don't have anything up. They don't have their usual. They do have a teleporter up. You can tell by the sparkles from Swordsman Scott. Swordsman Scotty, sorry. It's a name, not a nationality. As all the players are kind of mixed up together, and what is this random scout doing? He is just kind of dancing all around, trying to get out of the way of this crit, which just popped. Oh! How did Mercutio survive these? Looks like he stood for a second right in front of that crits, but he did survive. Will make it away alive. Oh, but... Oh. A lot of red players going down, so it looked like as Peyton went down, that would be the end of it for for Blue's push, but in fact they are able to hold on, and Red will get those respawns in order to push. High power, taking down Acer. Let's see. Oh, somebody's discovered that high power is right there. Oh, and then he covered himself with Girardi. I hate when that happens. Or it's worse when somebody runs in front of you and you cover them in Girardi and you didn't want that at all. Anyway, let's check out the very yes cam because we do need some engineer action. Basically, yep, just set up that level 1 sentry gun. It's going to have a battle now with... Oh, no, actually got taken out. That's all right. You have 100 more ammo to set it up again. Oh, but yes, is taking a lot of damage. He's going to have to get out of there. That's a fun little spot to utilize as an engineer. We do have 100% ready for the riot, the gerbils of the riots, as Blizzy did pop. Where did that pop go down? Okay, I'm not exactly sure what happened right there, but now he's being challenged by Scout. Random, however, has to fall back right there. Not sure why Random didn't push that. I guess he thought he was in more danger than he actually was. But regardless, Gerbil's holding on to the point as about 1 minute left for them to hold on. Simulate getting a nice shot right there on Power Gamer. He's been doing such great work right now, going after Blizzy again. Can he finish that? One more rocket off, and does take Blizzy down. Excellent, excellent work right here, controlling those crates, and he's just been doing a great job of that. Pretty much stopped that defense in its tracks, and now it's up to the rest of his team to, lend a hand and push in. Although the points really don't show how great he's been doing. But of course, points don't mean a thing in TF2, it's only about the hats. Oh, he does go down, because even the most mighty must fall. Red pushing on, and Golden Gents know that this is their last chance. Maybe their last chance. One of their last chances to hold on to the point. They do cap it. Slamdolph, though, goes down. X taking him down. Shots in the back, as Blue will push in with only 18 seconds left to hold on to the point, and they will take this round. And then we'll go to halftime. After somebody who wins 3 rounds, it is about halftime. And that means I get to take a drink of water because this has been ridiculously close and ridiculously exciting. Spy in on Peyton Manning, but Peyton effing Manning takes care of that. Simulate is somewhere bouncing around, and that's got to be extremely scary for Blizzy, who's only at 53% right now. There we go. Simulate does get taken down, and with that threat down, Insane Dribble Riot wins another round. So we will go 3-2 into halftime, and we'll be right back. We are back with the second half. Remember, we do have Gerbils leading it 3-2. So the Golden Gents are gonna have to get something going to make sure they stay alive in this game. We will go to 4 wins. So they definitely still have an opportunity, and definitely not impossible, because these teams have been ridiculously close match, as we have seen. Definitely gotta watch out for that pesky Soldier Simulate in terms of Blizzy's life potential, because he's severely been taking him out. We did switch teams, so now Gerbils are in blue and Golden Gents are in red. We have about close to 100% for both teams. Can't tell. We do have this 100%. I think it's a crits. Hobo Freddy, maybe we'll get it, so we'll stick on his cam as crits yet to be popped, even though we have both going strong. Blue team pushing on into the point. They will be able to take this. No crits or anything needed. And Hobo Freddy's kind of making me nauseous, so we're gonna get off of his cam. It's the Uber, and the Uber is popped as Red tries to push in right here. They had already popped, and it wore off. Blizzy goes down right there. What happened to the Gerbils? And now Mercutio is like, oh, wait, this is enemy territory. Yeah. But fortunately, his team pretty much dominating right there. As they were able to still hold onto that point, Will's trying to get some under action, and Hobo Freddy just trying to spam the point, as Golden Gen's trying very, very hard to hold on, but Will's goes down, and Gerbil's taking a lot of damage right here. Peyton is only about 100 health. He does get some heals. Swordsman Scotty connecting finally to take out that pesky Hobo Freddy, and Blue Team now starting to get the casualties that they do not want. So they're starting to be casualty there. Anyway, point goes to Red right there, as Gerbil Riot does take the point to Blizzy with about 70-80%. And let's see now. Blizzy is on crits. And Mercutio is on Uber, and they'll be getting them at the same time. And so we usually know how this story goes. We'll see if Gerbils can make something a little bit more useful out of this one than they did with their last one. No, they're going to pop it on Peyton Manning, and that's going to give way enough time for Golden Gems to get out of there and then pop their Uber in retaliation. And look at this. Now Wills is just going to like M1 and wipe out anyone he can, but actually not going to... He does take down Blizzy, so there you go. That's all that matters. As the rest of Golden Gents surrounding him and making sure Wills will survive. Mercutio survives as well. So that was a nice Uber pop and nicely timed Uber pop. Now, interesting enough, we do have Blizzy going Medigun, the regular Medigun, for the first time this match, I believe. He definitely likes his crits. Which I do too on King of the Hill, so you can't blame him for that. But definitely Gerbilrite has been... Golden Gents have been running that crits very effectively, so they need to adapt. They need to try to get that Uber for their own. Now, one thing we haven't seen a lot of is Spy Cams. S9 so far, 9 points in this half. Let's see what he can do. Did he just take... No, Swordsman Scotty went down to mini sentry. S9 gonna try to get the soldier right... Or a sniper right there, but Acer takes him out with a headshot. Really nicely done right there. And looks like we are having this Uber v. Uber fight. Gonna have some air blasting action in there. The dispenser pays the price. Blue Uber's gonna last for a little bit longer. They do finish off Peyton Manning. However, Blizzy got away, and they really should have gone after the medic right there. Blizzy is gonna push forward with the rest of his team. I don't know, this puts him in a very vulnerable position, and then there's still some spam coming forward. Blizzy needs to get out of there, and Mercutio needs to get some health, as both medics really, really hurt after that Uber exchange. So far, though, the point remaining in the red position. That's not the word I want. But anyway, Random finds a heavy covered in Girardi, goes after him. Let's see if he can finish off Medic right now. Blizzy, about 70 health, and oh, just one more shot, and this stinking engineer. Oh, wow, Blizzy does go down over. Will's got the kill. That jerk stole all of Random's hard work. But that definitely goes to Random. Taking out the heavy, first of all, and then, very nice job. Pro Jukes. I'm not sure what Juke is. Maybe Duke? I don't... Anyway, it was Pro, whatever it was. So, yes, it was Random. Yes, it was. We do have 100% ready to go for Golden Gents, as they just need to sit here and defend for a little bit more time. 20 seconds. That Uber lasts for about 8 seconds, so they can hold off on popping that as... Well, they need to hold off on popping that for as long as possible. As Red can't waste any more time, Simulate bombing in, taking out Bombero. Oh, Blizzy going down in that too. So here the Uber is popped. Blue did see their opportunity, and Golden Gents will take this round. And that means we are 3-3 tied going into the last round. So this is absolutely last round, as both teams trying to bring it all home right here. Both have put up a great fight and a great battle. We're gonna watch X, as we saw some nice work from Random earlier. So X, let's see what you got. Yes, we will remember you in logs. Let's see how he gets using the bomb to get behind the lines right here. Create some general chaos and distract people as well. Getting popped up right there. Gonna land him kind of close to the medic though, but everybody is on the X cam and takes him out. So no chance to do anything spectacular at that point. We do have both medics surviving. Blizzy, it looks like, is at crits, and Mercutio is on Uber. So same old as they have been doing in the previous rounds. So I guess Blizzy... Oh, yeah, let's see if this works. Swordsman Scotty, take it down, Vary, yes, and Hobo Freddy. Where is the combo holding is the question. They cannot find Mercutio with that 100%, and they do pop. Golden Gents pop just in time. Will's pushing forward. See how many kills they can't get with this pop. It was a little far back. Oh, and hey, there's a scout down on you. No, I am X. Takes down Mercutio with a nice, nice flank right there. And that is that little... underground garage, or whatever you want to call it, tunnel, which enables scouts to get in and behind and on your medic in like 2 seconds without you even realizing. So dangerous. So very, very dangerous, as you can see right there. Now, we haven't gotten too much spy play on action. Safety Potato is going for the big guy, not able to do so. As Very Yes actually finished him off right there. Let's talk about S9. Trying to go for some of these smaller guys, but nonetheless, they are guys, and their kills will matter. As Blue's pushed up very far forward right here, and now they just have to watch out for overextending. They can't push so far forward that Red Team gets in behind them and caps right from under their feet. Looks like they're doing a pretty good job holding, though. As Red is pushing on, S9, you're not doing anything. Oh, he's found the combo. He has found the combo, and this could be super bad. Takes out Heavy first. See if he can finish off this medic with 100%, and he does. He does. S9 with a great play right there. Taking out his Heavy, taking out Blizzy. No big deal. Whatever. Just, you know, all the spy's days work, right? But that's going to buy his team 100% uber advantage. Now they can push forward more with this uber if they want to. I would not suggest it. I would suggest it holding on to it. At this point, Red is going to come back very, very furious from that spy pick. So definitely have to watch the point. They need some presence up here on the crates to protect against Soldier Tree Man, who's also been doing a good job on the crates, but not he hasn't been as dominant as Simulate has. And we saw Random going down there, taking out Swordsman Scotty. Alright, we do have Treeman up here right now, so Blue Team, I mean, these teams know what to do, and you say Steel, and you're like, ugh, Steel, these guys are new, and these are new teams this year, but these guys know what they're doing. So, really, really fun to see these guys, and girls. I don't know if they're any girls, I'm sorry if there are, but really, really fun to see them compete. Oh, it looks like S9 timed out. He had too much awesomeness and his computer overloaded, I think, is the term for that. We will have a pause, though. Of course we will. We're going to get right back into the game, and now time does say it's run out, but pay no attention to that. The HUD is going to be messed up after that pause. We do have Uber on Uber fight. Two heavies not able to do anything to themselves. Red is flashing the Uber a little bit more, so they will run out faster, and indeed, Payton goes down right there. Somehow Blizzy got away alive, and actually he is on his own. He needs to get out, jumps across the point, and will connect with his, you know, scout and engineer. So why not? And that will be enough for the gerbils to come back and cap the point. So clutch right there. Of course, we stupid HUD will be messed up for a little bit longer, so I apologize about that. It's not like you need those countdowns in the last few seconds when ridiculously close games are happening. No, I mean, why would we need that? We're gonna watch Random as he goes for this little beneath the... Oh, hell yeah, look what I found! And oh, Exo in on him and protects his medic. Blizzy did take quite a bit of damage right there and has got to be watching his surroundings a little bit more carefully, especially as we are coming into the final seconds of this match. Golden Gents holding on for the first 2 minutes, but now now is Gerbil Riot's turn. We'll see if Random tries to go for that maneuver again, and he's gonna fall back, having a bit of trouble. Talk about trouble, High Power has found an invisible man to fight with, and that's no good. Oh! That was so cute the way he just popped his head out. Neither sniper, though, going down in that altercation. Oh! Pop! It's just like Whack-A-Moles, except instead of a soft mallet, you have a high-powered sniper rifle to take out your enemy. Anyway, High Power does go down there. And I'll refresh HUD real quick. It is going to freeze, but we have a 1:15 left for Gerbils to hold on to the point with only 30 seconds left for Golden Gents. It's going to be very, very difficult to hold on for 1 minute left because Golden Gents have been very, very aggressive, and once they do get the point after this 30 seconds, I have a feeling they're going to hold on forever. We do have the Uber popped on mid. Not sure about that pop. I'm guessing they were forced into it because just nobody was around for Blue to die from that. Red is just going to continue pushing forward. Source Muscati with a bunch of stickies there. Can he connect with any of them? No, not going to be able to, but he knows now where the combo is headed, so he can call that out to his friends. He's also going to try to get up there in the window and try to do some damage. Try to connect with an air pipe. I don't know if he got that, but that's Soldier taking a lot of damage, and Swordsman Scotty doing his best. That was Simulate, of course it was, who's going for those crate jumps. Does get taken down. Will's doing some nice I mean, sorry, that was Peyton doing some nice damage right there. Will's also doing some nice damage as he's pushing his team forward, but he overextends, and his meta goes down too. Oh no, this could seal the fate and for the Golden Gents, and I think it will. Oh, down goes Hobo Freddy. Ray just has to pop their Uber on the point, and a Dribble Riot in a very good position. Can anybody from Blue get back here? We do have Simulate. If anyone can do it, it's him, but he can't, and there we go. Insane Dribble Riot with the win. Take it 4-3 here on King of the Hill Arctic. Absolutely insane game. Back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. So finally, the Dribbles will survive and take this match. So thanks so much, for the person who sent this in. Oh, a Safety Potato. Safety Potato, thank you for sending this in. Good luck with the rest of your season, guys. I know as I post this, the postseason is already going on and whatever. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed the season. That's about it, guys. Thanks so much for watching. Have a good day.